the character of Ilya is a very unique one, because he's not crazy, and he's not even from their dimension. He's from a completely different dimension. The man from Uncle Dimension.
Bang!
Veronica, was I standing?
Oh! He's screaming about something, but I can't hear him anymore. Which is just as Sheila likes it.
His action. Sheila.
I gotta take it out of the thing. What the lemon reading is. Okay, ready?
I think our assassin has lost it.
Yeah. The concept for the man from the man from Uncle first came to life when my buddy Henry sent me a little video of himself talking in a Russian accent. I saw it and I laughed. And then later that day, it occurred to me that Henry happened to look like David McCollum, who is of course the character that Sheila McCollum is named after in the Darn Good Universe, because David McCollum is in the original Great Escape. And it occurred to me it'd be really fun to give a nod to David McCollum, not only in his role from the Great Escape, but also for his best known role of Ilya Kuryakin, the Russian spy from The Man from U.N.C.L.E.
With Ilya behind him, in character.
Preferably.
Ow! Stop!
The Man from U.N.C.L.E. was a TV show in the 60s. As Sheila says, it's kind of cheesy and far-fetched at times. And I love how Sheila points that out at the beginning of an episode that's literally going to bring dimension travel into our universe. It was definitely the type of show where anything could happen. Ilya Kuryakin was called upon to do pretty much anything, but his primary role was the cold, calculating assassin. And so, after consulting my partner in crime, Hopeless, about the opportunity of putting this character into our TV show, we contacted Henry and asked him if he wanted the role.
The character of Ilya Kuryakin in the TV show, The Man from U.N.C.L.E., he's as they describe him, a stone-cold assassin, and he's kind of like the killer of the duo between Napoleon Solo and, you know, Ilya Kuryakin.
When I first asked Henry about playing the role, I sent him clips of David McCollum playing Ilya Kuryakin, and I asked him to kind of unofficially audition for the role by doing some of those lines for me, you know, in his Russian accent. Sometimes his Russian accent is better and much more realistic than the one David McCollum did for the first season of U.N.C.L.E. And so we have some pretty cool parallels of Henry reading lines from the actual man from U.N.C.L.E.
I am Ilya Kuryakin. I am also an enforcement agent. Like my friend Napoleon, I do whatever I'm told.
And all through it, even the nights that we were filming, we'd watch Man from U.N.C.L.E. at night, and Henry just really studied the role, and I feel like instead of bringing a new character to the Darn Good Universe, he did a really good job being this character that already was created. Which is not an easy thing to do as an actor, and Henry just has this really good ability of mimicking what he sees, and at the end of the day, his resemblance to David McCollum itself is kind of uncanny.
It's crazy how much Henry looks like David McCollum. Like, it's insane. If you look at any young picture of him, I'm sure we'll put a picture up, but there's a picture of him somewhere out there. It looks exactly like Henry. Like, I don't care what kind of parallels we try to make with the other characters. Like, oh, well, they look like this and they look like that. It looks exactly like that. Put up the picture. It's crazy.
Henry has lived in Texas for many years now, which is basically the only reason he hasn't already had a role in the Darn Good TV show. We arranged for him to fly out for a weekend to film this episode. It was a crazy filming schedule. We had to pound out the whole thing in about 2 days, and that meant choreographing the fight scenes, filming everything.
Walking down the street on a normal filming day, got the script in one hand, handcuffs on the same hand, got the Sheila bag full of stuff, including my telephone and a noodle pin, and I'm off to find two morons.
I found the morons.
And then about 5 months later, when James came back to California, we filmed all the stuff that we couldn't get while Henry was here because of our time crunch that he wasn't in.
Bruh.
Which was really fun, because even though we're essentially making this TV show in two different states at a time, hence all the many phone call scenes that take place in the Darn Good Universe, it's best and most fun, obviously, when we can get as much of the cast and crew together on a set at a time.
Wait, you're gonna kill a guy?
We're at the line.
Oh.
Right. You're not getting
us
in the reflection, right?
Oh, look, is that a Bernadette?
So after I came up with the gimmick of having Ilya Kuryakin somehow end up in the Darn Good Universe, it was James who came up with the actual plot of how this would happen. And the dimension travel element was, of course, his idea, which is why it makes sense that Barking Steve is the one to figure out about this phenomenon in the movie.
there were a bunch of different drafts of how we were thinking about bringing Henry as Ilya Kuryakin there, but we decided that having him come in as someone from a different dimension would probably be our best bet.
My original concepts for this plot were way out of proportion. It would have been way too large of a movie to realistically film in our first season.
Is he on your...
Oh my god!
So it was really cool the way James could find a plot line where the gimmick worked, but it could be over quickly enough with this bounty on Sheila kind of a concept that we really didn't have to get too much into what Ilya was even doing in our universe. We just had to figure out how he got there in order to get him back out.
2000s research montage!
That was amazing.
I think I was quiet at some point.
This episode is kind of disconnected from the rest of the TV show and the way that it's kind of gotten a way out there idea about dimension travel. However, it is way connected in the way that it relates to the Nutcracker's plan to defeat the lunatics once and for all, which you will see in episode 11 and 12.
The concept of dimension travel was definitely a vehicle only for this episode.
However, I can confirm there will be no more dimension travel through episode 11 and episode 12, because this episode was the episode we wrote last and filmed last.
Okay, so here we go. We've got Dom shaded by the script and the Russian. All right, Dom, say your line. Wait, come on, Russian.
Okay, I'm still here. Here we go.
Focusing a little more on the character of Lee was a really fun idea because, first of all, we love putting Dominic in the limelight a little bit more because he's a hilarious actor.
Well, who would be able to do that?
Can you do it again? Because you just said...
Well, who would be able...
I'm talking!
Oh, sorry. Well, who would be able...
But also, it was the natural progression because Dominic portrayed Robert Vaughn's character in our spoof of The Magnificent Seven, so it makes total sense that he would have to again be Robert Vaughn in Robert Vaughn's role, Napoleon Solo from The Man from U.N.C.L.E. It was kind of weird how that worked out. We had these two actors perfect for these two roles from this other TV show.
Looking at the camera?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or me.
Okay, you or the camera?
Me.
You, okay.
In the final stages of writing the screenplay, and even once we'd started filming, there were some doubts about what the audience would think of Lee's character in this episode.
My hair be all wacko.
Wacko? That's true.
We were afraid that Lee could almost come off as kind of a villain in this episode, because the audience is used to following Sheila as the main protagonist.
Hard to make this much of a mess. Okay, ready?
So, we tried to make it very clear that Sheila's being very unreasonable. She's definitely more of her psychopath self in this episode than she was in something like Caution Contains Nuts. And so Lee's really caught in the middle between these very difficult combatants, and it's all up to him to figure it out. And he's kind of just been thrown in this job. So I hope it came across that Lee is doing the best he can with a very difficult situation, and he is quite a hero in this episode.
Come here.
I know he's gonna...
All of it goes this way.
Yeah. That okay? Doesn't matter. It's okay.
We're just doing this one knocking Dom out motion. Alright.
Now just hold it there.
Action.
Don't get eaten by the coyote.
What was the coyote?
It was running across the coast.
Right behind you. Alright, here we go.
I also like the fact that we made Lee the main character in this episode. Lee's spotlight, Lee's return. Lee comes back.
Just skedaddling?
Yeah.
Sorry.
And he tries to figure out what the heck is going on because Sheila isn't really in her right mind, just trying to kill Ilya, and Ilya just wants to bring her back. Lee wants to figure out what the heck is going on because some guy from a completely different TV show just appeared in his dimension, and he has no idea what the heck is going on, so he's just figuring the whole thing out. And thankfully, with the help of Greg and Steve, and the fact that he can just kind of keep them separated enough until they get there so that everything can work out, so that he can help them escape. Action.
How?
If it wasn't for Lee, they would have all been screwed. I'm telling you. They would have all been screwed.
When you talk about
Steve, I don't want to get mad at you
too.
For this entire time, I've been just been through the nightmare, okay? Can you stop for one moment?
Filming the fight scenes for this episode was probably the most fun element of the whole thing, at least for me.
Before you come into the shot. Then can you come into the shot and be like, guys, what's going on? And like kind of try to pull us apart.
Henry brought a large knowledge and training in martial arts to the table, and then we had to weave that into our knowledge of what looked good on camera. And of course, most of it was pretty slapstick. So most of the time, the fights were choreographed shot by shot as we went, just trying to figure out how we would get from place to place. A lot of times our cameraman Seth would start suggesting new moves for the fight since he was capturing it on film, and since he and I had already choreographed most of the fight scenes from Caution Contains Nuts.
Yeah, you're grabbing your...
You're grabbing your other arm.
Yeah.
But also keep with our typical darn good chaos.
You guys are both scrambling to your feet, okay?
Okay, I can scramble. It's almost 4 now.
Oh, I thought you were
talking to me to say it.
Alright, someone recorded that.
Okay.
I guess in a way, this episode is the story of what happens when two different versions of David McCollum in two different dimensions, two different universes of TV shows, collide, and I guess apparently we discovered they don't like each other. The Sheila McCollum and the David McCollum Ilya Kuryakin type, it's basically just gonna be a fight to the death when they run into each other.
Action.
This episode was a lot of fun to film, and it also kind of helped us break the barrier of the thought that friends who live here are the only people that can be in an episode like this. I mean, we literally flew this actor in for this role, which I feel like was a great feeling as movie makers to make something that official. Henry got quite the rite of passage as an amateur movie maker, being thrown in amidst sickness and incredible time crunch, fatiguing conditions. You can see Ilya and Sheila start to get more and more sunburned by the end of the movie. Lots of stunts, very fatiguing film schedule.
And then uppercut right to the chest.
Perfect. And of course, Henry is your typical actor, so after filming at night, he'd tend to party late with all his bros who weren't even in the movie, but who'd come to see him while he was in town. And it was really fun to have all those other guys on set as well, because they'd played their own roles in other episodes, and they're destined to return as the TV show approaches its finale. And so it was fun for them to be on a set of an episode they're not in so that they could help us out a lot.
It's a moose.
And also to be there for Henry and show him the ropes as part of the darn good cast.
That's really normal.
That's killing all my
No, we're not done. We were almost done, and then you decided to come in here.
I feel like the hardest thing for me and Henry to do, acting-wise, was to not have fun, or not look like we were having fun.
Ready?
You're not really good at this, are you?
And fight-wise, it was definitely hard to not look like we were trying to kind of go easy on each other.
I'm not gonna get on without a fight.
Sheila, stop fighting.
I can, and I will.
Sorry.
Or you can like actually punch me, that'd be kind of cool.
I did accidentally punch Henry in the nose for real.
There were occasions where we both tried very hard to make it look realistic.
There we go.
Sorry.
We both did accidentally hit each other in the face at least once.
Sorry, Henry.
You're good.
Oh, sorry.
That's good.
That's perfect.
Just smack your chin really hard though.
It's just hard when you're having that much fun to pretend like you hate the other person's guts.
Somewhat embarrassing.
Alright, ready?
Alright.
Popping in Easter Sunday, the darkest TV show we never sleep, so it's time to film Sheila's gunfight scene for the man from Uncle. Sheila's half of the original gunfight scene, which is, I think, the last pickup shot we needed, so no one was in town or anything for that. That got a little old. I think James made me film that at least 10 times on different occasions because it was never quite right, to the point where my own dog, who plays Barking Sam, started to be terrified of me because he thought I'd actually gone insane.
No, hush.
What is it? Is it a new car? Is it a yacht? Is it a hot air balloon?
So in the side plot, Sturges says that she has been given an assignment from Vatsa McCollum that says that she must secretly kidnap all the nuts.
Why am I looking at?
Quick, the line, Sturges! That was so in character, too.
Take them out of Hollywood and bring them to a new safe haven because the wardens are getting closer and closer to Hollywood. So she gets Tom to help her.
Oh, okay. What?
Guys, the writer has a suggestion.
I can't tell you.
I'm so excited! What is this?
So, Georgia, before we give it to you, I have to spin you around 5 times.
Okay!
Like, that's a super stupid.
Okay.
And you never know. maybe that will be expanded in episode 12 or episode 11 or episode 12. I mean, I don't know. You don't know. Maybe it will crescendo in the big finale. I don't know. I certainly don't know. It's not like I'm gonna forget. I don't know. Do you know? I don't know.
So the character of Ilya will not be returning to the Darn Good universe, at least anytime soon, because he's officially been sent back to his own dimension and his own TV show, where I hear he's quite successful, and where Napoleon Solo looks exactly like Arlie.
One cheap version of the
cat. I'm so intimidated, Ilya. Bang, bang!
But whatever happens to the other Ilya in that other world, even Sheila can put aside her differences and say that we wish him all the best, and we're glad that the Darn Good universe got a visit from the man, from Uncle.
Yay!
Good job!
It's wrapped!
Good job!
You did it!
Yeah.
I'm gonna roll my things for you.
Oh, God.
And now I'm out of time, but there's no way I can say goodbye. So I'll take my exit quietly, say I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.
Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, but thanks for watching. I don't know, I feel like I should say something like that. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Sorry for being late, by the way. I'm just gonna start talking. You can throw in anything you want. Hey, guys, sorry about being late. Hey, to be honest, it wasn't all my fault. You know who, Brenda Richards has kind of been slacking off. And I've just been like, I've been waiting and waiting and waiting. Oh, if it was all me, this episode would have been out in 9 months. I know, it should have been out in October. I would have gotten it out in September. I'm serious. That's right. I'm making a bold claim here. And if she puts that in, I mean, that just says more about her character than my character. Character, not in the TV show, as in just person character. But sorry about being late. We're catching up, though. We're catching up. Only got 2 episodes left. We're just going to release the featurette, which is this. So this is already done. So I'm talking from a past perspective. So the featurette's up. We just need to release the gag reel, which will be out soon, I'm hoping. If I say that and it's not going to come out soon, then truly, I'm an idiot. But, and then 11, all the 11 stuff comes out. And then after that, 12, and it's the big finale. And I'm hoping all that will come out in the summer. But yeah, that's what's going on with my life. How's it going on with you guys? Mm-hmm, right. Cool, right, awesome. All right, yeah. No, I don't. I don't know, what to type up. Oh, no way. Oh man, I'm so jealous. Dang it. That's sick though. Wow, that's awesome. All right, that's enough out of you. But you get what I'm saying though, right? So they will come out and we're sorry. But I mean, the past is in the past. So forgive us. Or not, or you don't have to. I'm not begging. I'm just saying, we're gonna put stuff out, okay? All right? All right, put in whatever you want, Burnett. I don't care. That all works.